Welcome to Insight Conversation. I'm joined today by Graham Stuart, UK Minister for Investment. Graham, can you tell us a little bit about your role within the department that you...
Well, DIT exists to promote the UK on the international economic front. So we do three simple things. We promote exports, promote investment, and we do trade policy. Everything from marquee trade deals to market access, changes for certain products or services. My role as Minister for Investment is to promote the UK as a centre for foreign direct investment and to support British companies as they build a footprint around the world. So it's a great job. I'm pleased to say that the UK is and retains its position as Europe's leading destination for foreign direct investment. That more than £1.3 trillion of foreign corporations investment in British companies, more than any country in the world other than the United States and China, Hong Kong. So we have been doing well, and under the latest UNCTAD, the UN figures for 2018, notwithstanding the uncertainties around Brexit, which country led Europe on foreign direct investment? It was the UK again. So we're in a strong position, but going forward, my job is to make sure we retain our position as the number one destination in Europe. That's my brief, and I'm delighted to be on the show with you today.
Great. I mean, where does energy security fit into that picture? I know that it's a key topic here in the UK. What are you doing to both encourage investment from overseas into UK energy and also help UK energy producers maybe go overseas and invest?
Well, it's obviously really important to the future of the British economy that we get the energy piece right. I think our recent record is pretty good. If you look at the continental shelf, then the changes that were made following the Wood Review, working with industry, led by industry, but then changes brought in by government have led to cooperation between industry and government, and a big increase in production from the continental shelf, significant investment by government as well into the technology centre, oil and gas technology centre. So we've done, I think, pretty good work there, and lifted ourselves up to the top quartile of profitability after tax. So the UK from an oil gas point of view is doing a good job. If you look at things like offshore wind, we have led the world in offshore wind, and by using the auction mechanisms we have, I see it off the coast of my constituency. Mm-hmm. We've seen a transformation in price and the development of a British supply chain. So I was in Taiwan earlier last year, met with the president, and we signed an MOU with Taiwan as they look to follow our example and develop offshore wind. So we're attracting investment in, but we're also seeking to support exports winds abroad.
What are you doing specifically to maintain Britain's position as a key investment destination post-Brexit?
Well, we have an FDI strategy. We have people in 108 countries around the world. We're a kind of like the promotional arm of UK PLC from a government point of view. But the most important thing is to get your basic environment right. So why we are so successful is because of the legal certainty in the UK, because of the regulatory continuity and consistency. We have the lowest corporation tax in the G20 at 19%, and we're lowering it further to 17%. And interestingly, every time we've reduced that level after the initial drop in take, we've then seen the take go up. We have more corporation tax receipts than ever before. So we are creating a truly business-friendly environment. And if you look at anything from tech, where we lead Europe by far, to higher education with innovation, the linkages between business, regulators, government, and higher education has never been so important in terms of development of technologies. We have four of the world's top 10 universities, and we're looking to strengthen in that way. So we've got a fantastic situation. Of course, the City of London, as the leading cross-border financial centre in the world, is another attractive piece. So by having world-leading universities, by leading Europe in terms of tech startups, we have more unicorns than any other European country. By getting the fundamentals of the system, like energy, right, then I think we're in a good position to attract people who want to do R&D spend, who want to be at the cutting edge, and we're recognized globally as an innovation leader. And since I took on this job just over a year ago, I've been pleasantly surprised by the remarkable alignment between what the world's looking for and what we're good at. You see great British engineering companies leading the world, from the Commonwealth Games in Australia to bidding for contracts in Latin America. There's a huge level of appetite for British goods and services out there, and my department is there to help encourage not only the investment to come in, but then when people do come in, to help export from here.
Leads us into final question nicely. Is there anything more you can do to keep the big global resource companies that base themselves here in London actually here in the UK?
Well, I think it's about getting, goes back to my earlier answer, it's about getting the conditions right, isn't it? Mm. So that's tax, regulation, the business environment, being supportive, and as far as my department is concerned, it's working hand in glove with those companies to win contracts abroad. I was recently in Belo Horizonte in Brazil, where the biggest investor in that state is Anglo-American. I was, as I say, in Colombia recently, and you look and meeting with the Peruvians. There's major investors, oil and gas, extractives, mining, all around, and we are, you know, we're doing a good job. But we can do even better. I don't think we've got it all right yet. My department's only 2 years old. There's at the moment, the opportunity there is in the world, and there is more opportunity than there is appetite at our end to meet it. So the UK government has a role to help create the conditions so that we can replicate in other areas and outside the UK what we've done so successfully in the UK continental shelf. Get the policies right, get the incentives right, work hand in glove with business, and listen to business. And the truth is, our future is a very, very positive one, and that's what my job is to help bring about.
Graham, thanks very much for joining me on Insight Conversation today. If you want more interviews from Platts, please log on to our website at www.smpglobal.com/Platts. Thank you.